All right, folks, we're going to talk today about how much vendors make daily, because that's one of the questions I got today. I got it twice today, and one of them asked a double question and said, how often, you know, how much do they work in a day? And that's something that is always, it was an exciting part of this business when I started, was because hot dog vendors don't work, you know, 9 to 5. We work typically from about 11 to 2. Now, let me be completely clear, completely honest with you here, is that when you are working, there's prep and there's cleanup. That's the times you ain't on the street. It's the time before and after, right? And you'll get better at that. And some vendors have it down to a science. You know, I've got a buddy, Michael Wood, with Doug's Dogs in Georgia, and he is just methodical. He's like he's got it down to a T. And so he knows exactly how much time it takes him to prep. He pre-preps for days in advance and does it like that. He vends part-time about 7 or 8 days a month. For years now, he's vended about 3 days a month, and now he's moved on up to 8, 9 days, sometimes 7 maybe. So anyway, so the income varies, and I've put a link in the comments, and I don't know if you can see that yet. I don't know how this works yet, but I'm moving from Facebook Lives to YouTube Lives, and then I'll share it on the Facebook page. This question did come from the Hot Dog Carts for Sale page on Facebook. But the gist is here. Most vendors, most average vendors go out and they have a value meal, or they have, you know, most people don't buy one dog. They buy two dogs. They buy a bag of chips. They buy a drink. So we create a value meal. I used to sell my value meal at $5. My food cost was about, once I got good at it, got about down to about 28%. It fluctuated between 28 and 30% depending on my drink costs for the most part, because those fluctuate a lot. So what I did is now most vendors are $6 to $8 for a value meal. My goal each day, because I'm an eternal optimist, almost painfully optimistic, was to make each day 100 sales, 100 meals, right? Now, that may be 65 customers, because some customers would show up, the sheriff's department show up, and they'd get 22 meals to go. And you'd bag them up and send them out with them. So if you do that kind of stuff, if you have a goal, you got to have a goal, right? So I did set my goal at 100. Now, sometimes I did 60. Sometimes I did 45. The point is, let's take an average, though. Let's say if you're in a good location, and I could go on a whole rant on locations, because most vendors think 5th and Main, got to be at 5th and Main. No, you don't. In fact, some of my friends, the pro vendors in our Vendors United group, are they're not at 5th and Main. You don't ever see them. You know, people call me from their town. Where is Jason? You know, where is Corey? Well, he ain't at 5th and Main, because they got gigs at hospitals. They got gigs at different places. But I'm not going to go on that rant right now. I'm going to just tell you about the income. But let's say you do 50 meals a day. Okay. 50 times 6, I'll take the low number of a value meal. That's 2 dogs, chips, and a drink. Now, if you're doing a quarter-pound dog, it may be 1 dog, chips, and a drink. So let's say you do 50 meals at $6. That's $300. Now, let's take out the vendor's average cost. The average cost is around 32% in cost. So I don't have a fancy calculator right now, so I'll do this in my head, kind of. It's about $95, roughly. 30 times 300 is 90, right? Yeah, 30% of 300 is 90. So it's a $90 to $100 is your food cost. So you made $200. You were out there from 11 to 1, let's say. But you got, let's say you're brand new. You got an hour of prepping to get, you know, prep beforehand, and an hour clean up, let's say, at the back end. That's 4 hours. Divide 4 into 200. You just made $50 an hour. Not that bad, right? And we've got many vendors that go back out in the evening and work a bar or work a dinner crowd. But typically, lunch is the time to do hot dogs, okay? Lunch, because it's not a substantial meal and it's a lunch meal. It's most people aren't going, man, what am I going to have for dinner? We got family coming over. Let's go get a hot dog. Nope. Most of them are going, let's go to Golden Corral or go to the steakhouse or something like that. It's considered a fast food. And it's why McDonald's and these guys do better at lunch than they do in the evenings. Now, could you do breakfast? Yes, we got vendors doing breakfast. I got one vendor that's been on our show several times, and he got so good at breakfast, he got so much business at breakfast, he just quit altogether doing lunch, period. He doesn't go out anymore during the day. He just does lunch. Now, most vendors also don't work. So if you see these fancy calculators online that say, look how much you make, and they have the thing where you fill it in, and some of them have it pre-filled in for you, $5 for your meal, and then it'll say, how many customers? 100. And then it'll say, how many days a week you're going to work? And they'd already be filled out at 5 or 6 days. And they go, look what you can make. No. Okay. Because you got weather and stuff, right? You have those things that come up, weather and emergency fishing trips, all kinds of stuff like that. So you cannot take it as I'm going to be working 5 days a week. No, you ain't. Okay. You might. A full-time vendor might get a good 4 days a week, and he's not going to get that 52 weeks a year. He's going to get that about 35 weeks a year average. That gives you a bunch of time off. You'll make a full-time income in your 35 weeks or 32 weeks a year, and you will have a full-time income. I know an older couple that have a cart on a boat. I'm going to do a course on that later, and I'll do a live video about it as well, just a short training video. But they have, because we got a lot of vendors doing that now. But they're on a boat, and they only work about 4 months a year. They make enough in those 4 months, they don't work the rest of the year. Do they work their butts off those 4 months? Abso-freaking-lutely. Okay, I promise you, they work their butts off. So there's many, many things you can do to change those numbers, and that's what we teach in Vendors United. That's what I teach over at LearnHotDogs.com blog. If you go over there, you'll see it's free information. Just grab some. If you want to know, you know, like today, I probably got 40 or 50 questions just on Facebook today alone, not counting the emails, not counting at Hot Dog Cart Store. And a lot of those questions could be answered right at the blog, learnhotdogs.com. But I'll try to go through them again here for you. So it's really... that kind of deal. Now, the hours, I answered that question while I was giving you the math, the breakdown from the $200. That's about what an average vendor does. We had a brand new vendor, I think it was yesterday or today. They did, I want to say $268. Okay. And if you take out their food costs, and I'm going to figure that at 30%, 30 and 260 is something like $75. And so they made about 180 for a lunch shift. Not bad. But let's say you had to work 8 hours a day, a normal job, a J-O-B, 8 hours a day at $180, like this brand new vendor just did, $180 take home money. That's, what's that? 8 into 180. I don't know the math on that, but it's close to $20 an hour or something, right? It's a little over $20 an hour. If you did it, if it was an all day deal, which it wasn't. So not bad money. It's not for everybody though. It's still work. It's still a job, but you own the job. Tomorrow, if you know, my granddaughter has a recital, I can go to it. If my, grandson has a dentist appointment, and I got to be the one to pick him up, I can go. And that's the benefit. It gives you freedom to choose when you work, when you don't. You still have to be responsible. You still have to kick yourself in the butt and get out of bed and start your day and get out there and take advantage of the really good days and start taking advantage of those good locations. Richard asks, Richard Barber, thanks for being here. Can you touch on the pros and cons of a sole proprietorship versus an LLC? Yeah, I can a little bit, but I have to preface this. Every time I talk about this, I have to preface this because we have an attorney. His name's David Webb. And he says that I usually can read something and it ain't here. It's like a disclosure thing. Bottom line is, I ain't an accountant, ain't a lawyer. This is my opinion only. It ain't considered tax advice, legal advice, or be misconstrued as tax or legal advice. That's the gist of it, right? So pros and cons of a sole proprietorship. It is the benefits of an LLC or any type of corporation far outweigh the benefits of a sole proprietorship with the federal government, okay, your IRS. Now, if you have state taxes, I don't know because every state's different. But here's the cool thing that many people don't know. You can be a sole proprietor from January 1 or any time in the year you want. Start as a sole proprietor because it's cheaper to start, okay? That just means you go get a business license in your name and you DBA it, doing business as Bob's, Big Dogs and Sausages and Catering, right? So you put that down and that's your DBA. And then you start and then you work all year. As long as you convert that by December 31st over to an LLC or an Inc., you now have, it retros all the way back to when you started. So it will be as if you get the tax benefits all the way back to when you started as a sole proprietor. So you don't have to be an LLC or an Inc. in the beginning because you pay your taxes by April 15th, right? Well, that gives you, you know, those 4 months for your accountant to go, okay, you were a sole proprietor for the first 11 months and 30 days. No problem. You converted on December 31st. No problem. You now were an incorporation for that whole time. That's all there is to it. It's not a lie. It's not fake. That's just the way the IRS has it set up. Once you convert it, it goes back to when for that physical year. Okay. LLCs definitely protect your personal assets better. But now with the new laws, lawyers can go in there and find members because LLCs don't have owners, so to speak. They have members, and members can then be sued. So they can still get you. They can still get you. If a lawyer's still breathing, they'll figure out a way to get you, even with an LLC. Inks now have become more popular of recent for tax relief than LLCs. Plus, LLCs at one point had the better deal. And then the states went, oh, too many people were doing LLCs. And then they raised the price of the LLC like to $650 to start it. And then just for the LLC, and then a whole different paperwork packet. And so with the IRS and the state. So then everything's come back around. What you'll want to do is contact a tax professional. Many of them are online. Many of them are free advice online. Many of them have blogs and podcasts and radio shows. You can find the information you want. But if you had to, start as a sole proprietor. If money's tight, start as a sole proprietor and then go into it. Avid Hiker, thanks for bringing that up. It is true. An LLC will give you some layer more of protection than a sole proprietor will. Okay. But you can protect yourself sole proprietor-wise by insuring yourself, okay? So you can get insurance for about $299, covers you for $2 million, and you can even add additional insurance. On top of that, you could stagger it. Then if they went after you and they go, he's got a hot dog cart, we'll sue his insurance company. Insurance company has good lawyers because they have your money, my money, and everybody else's money. And they can afford the good lawyers. Thanks. Boston Street Eats and Catering in the house. I'm going to bring this up real quick in case somebody's particular is watching that asked me today about their name. They gave me like four different names they'd come up with. None of them said catering. None of them. If you notice, Bugs Moran is here. He said Boston Street Eats and Catering. And you're going, Ben, why are you saying and catering? You need to look at the free training videos. You got to add and catering. I'm going to tell you there's a multitude of reasons, and maybe I'll come back with that. Tomorrow I will be back with something else. I got a bunch of questions I want to go through. Thanks for being here. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it helped you. If you have any questions, put them here or message here on YouTube, and it will be easier for me to find them because it emails me the message rather than Facebook where I have to go in there. I have to remember to go in there. And then some people put it in the post to the page. Some people message it. I never can find. Some people put it in the comments. It's like a cluster. All right. Y'all have a good one. Talk to you later.